हरि ओम।
हरि ओम।
हरि ओम स्वामी जी।
हरि ओम। Many of you are joining. I think Vignesh ji, we can start. I request everyone to put on your cameras. Last time Swami Anukulanand ji has given us a guidance. When your camera is on, you are more serious. Otherwise, you put on off the camera and you tend to do so many other things in the background which you do not know. The whole meeting may get little bit distorted. So this is a request, though we cannot make it compulsory. It will be nice if you can put it on so that we can see each other. Yeah. Vignesh ji, shall we proceed?
Swamiji, yes, Swamiji.
Yeah. So Padma, please start, put on your camera and we can start with the...
Hari Om. On this auspicious evening, I, Padma, welcome you all present here for this online motivational talk by Brahmachari Vignesh Chaitanya. Pooja Gurudev says, catch them young and give them your love, inspire them to lead a life of noble values and self-dedicated service. You can then be sure of nation's glorious present and bright future. It gives me a great pleasure to inform you that Chinmaya Yuva Kendra Ponda has started a motivational talk series by different Swamis and Brahmacharis of Chinmaya Mission all over India. Last month, we were blessed to have Swami Anukulananji from Chinmaya International Residential School, Coimbatore. Today, we are extremely fortunate to have Brahmachari Vignesh Chaitanya Ji, who will guide us by his motivational talk on the topic, Decode the DNA, Finding Our Passion and Purpose. I welcome Brahmachari Vignesh Chaitanya Ji. Hari Om Vignesh Ji, welcome and my pranams. Before any endeavor to proceed, it's our tradition to invoke blessings of Almighty Lord. Now I request Shivam to say the invocation prayers.
Hari Om, am I audible?
Yes.
गुरु बिन कौन बताए बाट, गुरु बिन कौन बताए बाट, गुरु बिन कौन बताए बाट, साच की राह दिखाए नित डांट, साँच की राह दिखाए नित डांट, गुरु बिन कौन बताए बात, गुरु बिन कौन बताए बात। ज्ञान अज्ञान का अंधेरा मिटाए, ज्ञान ज्ञान का अंधेरा मिटाए, ज्ञान ज्ञान का अंधेरा मिटाए, शरण आए को सवेरा दिखाए, शरण आए को सवेरा दिखाए, खुश रंग समझना आए बात, खुश रंग समझना आए बात, गुरु बिन कौन बताए बात, गुरु बिन कौन बताए बात, साँच की राह दिखाए नित डांट, साँच की राह दिखाए नित डांट, गुरु बिन कौन बताए बाट, गुरु बिन कौन बताए बाट, गुरु बिन कौन बताए बाट।
थैंक यू शिवम। We have two active Chick centers in Goa, Chick Ponda and Chick Korchoram. Under the guidance of Swami Sughoshananji, Chinmaya Mission Ponda conducts two Chick classes. Junior Chick class, for which text Why Do We in Indian Culture is discussed, and a manual of self-unfoldment for Senior Chick. I request all of you to join these classes and get to know about our culture and true self. Today we are very blessed to have Pujya Brahmachari Vignesh Chaitanya Ji. Now I request Swami Sughoshananji to introduce Pujya Brahmachari Vignesh Chaitanya Ji.
Yes. Hari Om. I hope all of you can hear me.
Yes, Swamiji. Can hear you.
Yeah. Vignesh Ji, I wholeheartedly welcome you to this program. And I think last year, Vignesh Ji was supposed to be with us for the All Goa Children's Camp, but Mr. Corona disturbed our schedule, and that was postponed. We do not know when now, but it is good that Vignesh Ji is with us today in this beautiful evening for youngsters, guiding youngsters. Brief biodata of Brahmachari Vignesh Ji. Vignesh Ji attended the Youth Empowerment Program, which is conducted by All India Chinmay Yuva Kendra. So he was from the first batch of Yuva Veer, which was conducted in the year 2003. And in this period, Vignesh Ji has served Andaman and in Tirunelveli. He has guided the youngsters in his seva period in nation building. Thereafter, he in 2011 and 13, he has done the Vedanta training course, which is conducted by Chinmaya Mission in Pawai, Sandipani Sadhanalaya. And presently, he is posted in Coimbatore Center of Chinmaya Mission, and he is overlooking, along with other prachar works, the Chinmaya Vidyalaya students, guiding them, motivating them in different areas of their spiritual and moral and cultural growth. Vignesh Ji has conducted several workshops for school teachers and principals of different schools, not just Chinmaya Vidyalayas, but other schools of our nation, and on the art of teaching and value-based and vision-based education. He has also addressed corporate houses like TCS, Synthite Group, Ashoka Leyland, Orchid, LIC, Hyundai, research scholars, medics and paramedics, BPOs on leadership, relationship, group dynamics, teamwork, vision, and success. On all these topics, he has been guiding, continuously guiding these business houses. And he also addresses different students, especially he loves to be with children and youngsters. And he goes to different schools. And now the days of lockdown and the corona, he does it right from his room via online classes on Zoom. And he takes workshops on the topics like goal setting, leadership, concentration, time management, mind management, emotional intelligence, patriotism, and many more such very, very important topics in the lives of youngsters and all of us. So he has given motivational talks to Tamil Nadu state football team also. So also he has addressed international yoga teachers from Argentina for well-being and happiness. He is a sportsman, likes to play soccer, cricket, basketball, volleyball, tennis, etc. His hobbies include listening to music. He loves to read. He loves to trek. And he is a biker, especially in Himalayas. He is wandering in Himalayas, you can say, on his bike and watching nature and traveling and being with kids and youth. This is are his areas of interest. He is council member of All India Chinmay Yuva Kendra in Tamil Nadu state, and there is much more to his dynamic personality. And though he does wonderful work at national and international level, he doesn't share much of his information in our Acharya's groups. I just now requested him to share whatever unique programs that you do, so that it is a motivation for all of us to carry out such programs in our centers as per our capacity, or even online inviting yourself also, we can have such programs in Goa also. In 2009, we went to a group of Ponda, members of Chinmay Mission Ponda went to Andamans, and Vigneshi, he was in white that time, and he saw to it that while we were in Chennai, Niranjan must be knowing, Niranjan is part of that, he was a small boy that time. So he took all the, what you call it, mehnat to make all the arrangements for us in some hotels also, and later on we came to our Chennai. And that's how he has helped us in the past. So I once again welcome Brahmachari Vignesh Ji in this online session for youngsters on decoding the DNA, and over to Padma for the proceedings. Hariyam.
Thank you, Swamiji. Now I request Swamiji to start the session, enlighten and boost us with energy and enthusiasm. We shall have a question and answer session at the end of the talk related to the topic. You can keep your questions ready by then. We request you all to be present for the entire session and not leave in between. We also request you all to keep your camera on throughout the session. Hari Om.
Om Sahanavatu, Sahanavunatu, Sahaviriam Karavavahai, Tejas Vinavadi Tamastu Mavit Vishavahai, Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om Shri Guru Pyonamaha, Hari Om Shri Ganeshaya Namaha, Om Shri Saraswati Namaha, Om Shri Guru Pyonamaha, Samasta Jana Kalyane Niratam Karunamaya. Namami Chinmayam Devam Sadgurum Brahmavitvaram, Om Shri Chinmaya Sadgurave Namaha. My pranams to Swamiji, Swami Shubhoshananji, and thank you, Padma, for that beautiful moderating. And Shivam, such a beautiful invocation. Thank you for invoking the Lord for all of us. So when Padma said, keep your questions at the end of the session, that is for the audience to ask. But I also can ask questions, right? I can start with a question, isn't it? So, Swamiji's initiative is very, very appreciable. Introducing a lot of people from all over India to talk to all the young people, to give them some inspiring inputs, which makes them find a purpose, or to identify their talent, or to find a meaning to their life, or find joy, the real joy. So I really appreciate Swamiji's beautiful initiative. This is very important initiative. Why important is because in this period of challenging times, our mind tends to look out for, either our mind looks out for solution or goes in the negative direction. It's where what is inside us, which determines whether we go for solution or we go for solace or we go for sorrow. It's all inside us. So when we don't get the right inputs, our mind usually goes for trying to find a solution, but do not know where. And whatever said and done about this corona, Swami said this Mr. Corona was the one which made me not go there. But I'm able to meet Swamiji here online, though it is not giving that connect. And I really enjoy spending time with our Sugho Shanaji because he's such a very jovial person, very full of vibrance. And you do not know where that next joke comes from. Very serious discussions will happen. Suddenly, out of the blue, he will crack something. You have to be very alert to catch it. So though Swamiji was saying about this corona has been a hurdle, but it has helped us to connect wherever we are from. Anyways, most of us are connected through the gadgets to people. That real-time connection is very less nowadays, but at least we are very comfortable connecting with gadgets. If you see, people will be sitting next to each other, friends, basically, and they would like to say hello to them. They will not say hello like this. They will say hello from their mobile. Hey, how are you, da? That fellow will say, I'm fine, da. There, next to each other. We are so comfortable with our mobiles, not able to connect real time. Okay, whichever platform we are comfortable, we are able to use it for a very good purpose. So right now, what we have done is this initiative is very good. And Swamiji has invited a lot of speakers. So I would like to know, because I don't want to repeat certain ideas, because you know we all come from the same background. So there may be some incidents and anecdotes or stories, or I know repetition is very important for us to keep us remind what we are going through. But I would like to ask if anybody has attended on a regular basis, what is the takeaway from the previous session? Like Anandji had addressed, I think Anukulanji has addressed, Anandji addressed. I know whoever is addressed it. I request any of the participants, Swamiji will say, but I want the participant who has participated before. Can you share any one takeaway? Like, yeah, this session I went through and beautiful point I came across and I'm reflecting on it. Or I'm trying to apply it. Anybody here? Can you raise a hand or... I think Padma is regular, or Niranjan and Shivam obviously are the regular people. Can you share one takeaway, Niranjan or Shivam or Padma?
Pooja can also share.
Pooja. Yeah, Pooja.
Pooja Tritiya. Yeah.
Can you share one takeaway, one point, which you thought like it was a very beautiful point? And it really touched me. Any point? Pooja, Padma, Niranjan, Shivam, Tritiya.
Yeah. Shivam. Actually, like I would like to say one point which was mentioned by Anukulananji, where he gave different shapes activity he gave. He gave different shapes and...
Yeah, go on, Shivam.
He
can
hear you. Yeah. So he gave different shapes and he told us to draw this shape, you know, this shapes. And but when he drew that shape, through that shape, he built a house. So usually, like he told that difference between a vision and profession. So our vision is important, he told mostly. So where I also got that point, so where if vision is only not clear or then we can't find a way towards anything, to a particular thing or anything.
Good. Thanks, Shivam. It was very interesting that it's a very beautiful point. You were able to connect to this point because of the demonstration. So that's very important when we are doing a session. When we are using some kind of a demonstration or example, it's easier for us to connect. So you are able to connect through that activity, that vision is important. How we perceive, what we listen, how do you process it in our mind, and how we present it to the world is very important. Yes, Bharatiji, you wanted to share?
Hari Om, Vigneshji. The first session, which was by Swami Swatmanandi, which was on how to remain inspired at difficult times. In that, it was very much pertaining to the situation around us, where there's so much uncertainty and you just don't know what's going to happen next. So there was one slide of his which said, troubles teach us to be strong. So where we push our limits, the struggles strengthen our character. So that was something that, you know, was a takeaway message for me from Swatmananji's session.
Very good point. Thanks for sharing, Bharatiji. That troubles push us to go beyond our limits. If that perception or if that vision is there, then the life becomes more easier for us to approach it. Yeah, anybody else wants to share? Any other point? Somebody from Anukulanji, somebody from Swatmananji.
I would like to share a point from Anukulanji's session.
Yeah.
He told that we need to come out of our comfort zones to explore life. Mm-hmm. We always tend to be in our comfort zones all the time. So if we want to do something different, then we need to come out of our comfort zone first.
Very nice, Pooja. That's very important. So what's your comfort zone? Did we come out of it? Did we try to do something about it? Comfort zone. What's your comfort zone? Your little room, your teddy bear, your gadget. What is your comfort zone where you are stuck up, not able to go out? Did you make an effort?
I have stage fear, so I don't talk too much.
Nice. See, now you're talking in front of people. So many people. I'm very happy. See, one idea that come out of the comfort zone has changed your perception of stage fear. Very, very happy, Pooja. Good. Yeah, good. Anyways, now I understand from what all you said, Swamiji had spoken about vision, clarity, and Swatmananji has spoken about how you have to face the challenges in life. Third point, what she said, or Pooja said, was from comfort zone to the effort zone. Very important. Yes, each one connects to a particular idea in a different way. We are all uniquely different. And that's so special about us. So all of you heard the same talk, but each one's catching a point is very different. How is it different? Because of our DNA. Each one is unique because of our DNA. So what is this DNA we are talking about? Scientifically, we say DNA, RNA, and that makes the entire system, the chemical reactions happen, and that's why we are. Okay. All these are all papers which people are trying to prove to us that each one's unique capacity or each one is so different is because of this DNA strand in us. But that is something beyond this. That makes that DNA to behave that way. DNA is just an organ. DNA is just a matter. But how can matter behave like that? There should be some consciousness behind that matter which makes that DNA function. Am I getting the point? Somebody should say yes or no, like thumbs up. Otherwise, I don't know. I'll just keep talking. Is it understandable? The DNA is just a matter. When the life goes away, the DNA in the body is still there, but doesn't function. Isn't it so? So there is something beyond the DNA which makes the DNA function that way. So what is this DNA which makes us function the way we are? Science doesn't have an answer. Recently, the science is saying that consciousness is behind all these things. Now, when you see the entire world, people are talking it is matter and energy. Now, slowly people are saying energy is a different expression is matter. Matter and energy are not different. So science is slowly trying to unravel the mystery of this creation, mystery of this plurality, mystery of why we are like this, how we are like this, where are we going? Science is doing a lot of research on it, but our rishis were far advanced in their vision. In their meditation, they were able to understand all this process which happens in a body happens because of consciousness. The consciousness is the principle which makes the entire DNA or RNA or chemical reactions to process. Something leaves the body, the body's chemicals are still in the body, but it doesn't function. So something is beyond that. And what is that? What is that is what we say conscious principle. And now recently science is really, really progressing into that area where they are saying that entire universe is consciousness. So the DNA, how to decode this DNA? Why am I and what am I? If I know what am I and why am I, I'll be able to work or live in this world the way I want to live. Many of us in this world have a question mark. Why? Right from childhood, when you are all growing up, you asked your mama, why? We are very curious, right? Our mind is very curious. It always wants to know. It wants to understand better. What is that factor which wants us to make us know? Why? What? How? Where? When? All these questions, it's only in the syllabus of a human being, not with the animal, right? Animal doesn't question anything around its environment. It just lives, responds to the nature, responds to the circumstances. Yes, it is also growing, evolving. But the way we evolved and the animals evolved are totally different scale. We have evolved very faster. How did we evolve very fast? Because of our inquiry, because of our questioning ability, because of our observation. What is this factor which makes me question, inquire? That is very unique about us. And that is the most important strength for all of us to reach our goal. Please understand, a fish is being given the ability to swim. A bird is being given the ability to fly. What is the ability given by Bhagavan to a human being? The ability to question. The ability to ask a question. Inquire. Are we inquiring or just passively following? Most of us have been trained and habituated just to follow, not to inquire. Very few people inquire, question. The few people who inquire and question are the ones who are successful in life, who grow forward in life. People who just follow, people who just accept whatever things are happening around, they just grow very slowly, but not the way they want to grow. You see, right from the beginning of the time, in our Shastra, the entire Vedas, the Puranas, Itihasas, everywhere you will see only questioning, inquiry. The Upanishad is full of inquiry. Are we inquiring? So this is the question which we should ask us. The DNA, decode the DNA. What is this decoding the DNA? The life and the consciousness, which makes everybody alive. What is this which makes me alive, which makes me listen, which makes me process, which makes me respond? What is this? Please think. Please understand, life is a miracle. Whatever life, it is a miracle. And whatever we are born, every life is a miracle. And if you understand the way we are all born, you will be so amazingly wonderstruck how we are born. You know how a mother and a father come together and how the mother carries the fetus in the womb. It's a single cell, goes on to become multi-cell. And then after the 8th month, the 9th month, it turns around. Who told it to turn around? No idea. And then once it turns around, have you seen the skull of a newborn baby? It is not completely made. You touch the top of the head, it is throbbing. Why? Because the skull is not complete. Why the skull is not complete? Everything is created. Why the skull is not complete? Because the child has to squeeze through the mother's pelvic girdle and come out. So it is, the nature has made it to go adjust and comes out. And the process itself is so, if you are a biology student, if you're a student of life, you will understand it is such a beautiful form of how a child is formed and how a child is come out. In Aitreya Upanishad, the beautiful process is created, how the fetus is created, how the child is born. Such observation has been done by our rishis in the Upanishad. Why I'm saying is, please understand, life is a miracle. And we are all miracle. Huh? And also, you know that we are a star. You know we are a star? We are a superstar. Do you all feel like you are a superstar? Not only Rajinikanth is a superstar, huh? We are also a superstar. Because some parts of the universe, some parts of the star are also in us. Do you know that? We also carry some kind of these minerals, chemicals that form a star is there in us. So you are also a superstar. Do you feel that you are a superstar? Do you feel that I am a superstar? We all think superstar means I should dance, I should sing, I should eat a couple of villains, and then I should have a big cutout. Then I'm a superstar. No. You know, your mother is a superstar. Your father is a superstar. Your teacher is a superstar. Your friend is a superstar. And you are a superstar. Do we feel that way? Why aren't we feeling that way? Nobody has told us you are a superstar. Everybody right from childhood, they say, you're stupid, you're dumb, you're keeping on telling us you don't know what to do in life. Come on, what is this? Get up, do this. What do you know? Don't you know this? Keep on people telling us so much of negatives right from childhood, criticizing all the time. For whatever good reasons or bad reasons, we have heard more negatives than positive. So what happens is we think, that is why our teachers are so important and special, our mother and father, because they keep on looking at the good things in you and they keep on touching the good things in you. So first point I would like to say is, please tell yourself you are a superstar. Yes, when you go out, nobody will respect it. Everybody will say you are a failure. You yourself will feel, what am I? When you are competing and comparing with others, you will feel you are nobody. But please understand, Amrutasya Putraha. You are not son of a sinner. You are son of an immortal self. When you know that, how much of confidence and how much of joy we get out of it, how much of confidence we get of it. Just imagine, you are the one. Do we feel I am the one? I am so special. Yes, whatever, however people can say, I am special. Let us recognize that factor. Let us first understand that we are the special ones and we are a miracle in life. So now I'll just show you a small video. I am a miracle. So I don't know what next. Next what? I am a miracle. So what? I'll just share a video. It's a very beautiful video.
Asked his father, what is the value of his life? Instead of answering, the father told his son to take this rock and go sell it at a market. If anybody asks the price, raise two fingers and don't say anything. The boy then went to the market and a woman asked, how much is this rock? I want to put it in my garden. The boy didn't say anything and raised up two fingers and the woman said, $2, I'll take it. And the boy went home and told his father, a woman wants to buy this rock for $2. The father then said, son, I want you to take this rock to a museum. If anybody wants to buy it, don't say a word and just put up two fingers. The boy then went to the museum and a man wanted to buy the rock. The boy didn't say a word and just put up two fingers. And the man said, $200, I'll take it. The boy was shocked and went running home and told his father, a man wants to buy this rock for $200. His father then said, son, the last place I want you to take this rock is to a precious stone store. Show it to the owner and don't say a word. And if he asks the price, just put up two fingers. The son then went to a precious stone store. He showed the rock to the owner. Where did you find this stone? It is one of the most rarest stones in the world. I must have it. How much would you sell it for? The boy put up two fingers and the man said, I'll take it for $200,000. The boy, not knowing what to say, ran home to his father. Father, there's a man that wants to buy this stone for $200,000. His father then said, "Son, do you know the value of your life now? You see, it doesn't matter where you come from, where you're born, the color of your skin, or how much money you were born into. It matters where you decide to place yourself, the people you surround yourself with, and how you choose to carry yourself. You may have lived your whole life thinking that you were a $2 stone. You may have lived your whole life surrounded by people that saw your worth for only $2. But everybody has a diamond inside them. And we can choose to surround ourselves with people that see our value and see the diamond inside of us. We can choose to put ourselves in a market or put ourselves in a precious stone store. And you can also choose to see the value in other people. You can help other people see the diamond inside of them. Choose the people you surround yourself wisely. And that can make all the difference in your life. I love you all.
So basically, you got the point what he's trying to say? Everybody has a diamond in them. How and where you choose to put the diamond determines the value. If you put yourself, if you don't feel that you have a diamond, first of all, then we can nowhere go forward. And you have to also choose the people who will identify the diamond in us. Please think. So basically, the first point we were discussing is life is a miracle. And please understand the value of life. Life is so special. Right from the beginning of time, human life has been very, very special. Why human life is very, very special? Nandita, can you say why human life is very special? Nandita, I can see Nandita there. Because whoever is in the screen, I was just saying. Can you tell me why is a human life so special? Can you hear me? No. Okay. Try again, fail again. Who is that boy? Can you say why a human life is so special? We have emotion. Good. Even a dog has an emotion. You give something, it'll come and lick you. If you throw a stone, it'll come and bite you. Anybody else? Why human life is so special? You can raise a hand. We can. You can answer. Why a human life is so special? Aditya Prabhu, yeah, please.
Swamiji, we have curiosity, and the curiosity is different from that the other animals have, as you said.
Good. The curiosity, you know, a deer is very curious and a monkey is even more curious. That's why it's the closest cousin to us, a chimpanzee. It's very, very curious. Anything else? Yes, curiosity is there. Anybody? Ability to think and ponder. Yeah, Rupaliji.
Yes, I want to say the same thing. The thinking capacity is more in humans than others.
Thinking capacity is also in every being which has a mind.
Okay.
Pondering, it may not do. A monkey will not sit and ponder, why did he not get this chocolate? Why he got that chocolate? What is my next food? Next food it may think. But ponder, monkeys don't do. But thinking it does. Ganesh Tantriji.
A dog once born dies as a dog. And a cow dies as a cow.
Yeah.
But you know, I think we are the only species which have a choice, you know, to decide the direction we take in our life, you know. We can be anything. But we can also drive our life in the direction we decide to drive.
You know,
so that choice probably is not available to any other species of life, I think.
Good point. Just a moment. My internet connection, is it good? Are you seeing my face clearly or it's all breaking?
It's breaking a little bit.
The screen is entirely shaking, Vigneshji. Some problem.
Yeah, that's what I'm trying to disconnect this. Is it okay now? No?
No, it's the same.
It's the same, no? I don't know. I've changed.
Your power is connected. Suddenly it
becomes... Yeah, I know my power is there. My network, usually this happens because of the bandwidth. I changed the network also.
But we can...
Yes.
Clearly.
Yeah. We'll... Man can be born in ordinary, but he has potential to become extraordinary. I think he has listened to our Anukul Anji and say man is born in ordinary, he can become extraordinary. Very true, very true. Just like as Ganesh, you were saying. Just. Okay, I will switch off my video. Okay. Now only Asiriri you will hear. Asiriri means only Vani. Podcast kind of a stuff only you are going to hear. My network is very bad. I'm sorry. I've tried two networks. Yes. So what Ganeshji was saying was that we have the choice to live the life of a human or go beyond and reach the maximum potential. So this is very unique in a human being. So how do we do? How do you go about it? So let us start with a small PowerPoint presentation. Chick, can you share a presentation? Yeah, so they decode the DNA. And next slide. Life is a miracle and an opportunity to reach our maximum potential. That's what we saw. And we can make a difference in our life and other people's life. But how? Next slide. Now you see, we all think if you want to make a difference, I have to own a company. I have to achieve great things, make a difference. But don't you think all these people are making a difference in our day-to-day life? Our understanding of success is so determined by the society. When we see a mother, we don't think she's a successful person. We think, what has a mother done to us? Like, for the particular context of saying that, yes, this is what is success. A mother is successful. And a teacher is also successful because she is sharing whatever she has got to the society. And each and everyone here in the screen are so engrossed in and so much contribution, certainly they are living an extraordinary life. But we don't see that. We always think like ordinary and extraordinary in the terms of like achievement. No, it not be. If a mother makes a rasam at home, that is extraordinary. The way she makes it, it's so special. You can't find that same rasam anywhere in the world. Is it so? Your mother's rasam, you can never touch and anywhere it cannot be replaced. So it is unique. It is so special. It is extraordinary. It's not like any of the hotels. And each and every one who is here has an extraordinary potential. But are we thinking in that direction that even small act can we do extraordinarily? Our thought is what is important here. Yeah, next slide. Jay, next slide. Yeah, living extraordinary. If we want to live extraordinary, we have to derive an inspiration to do our actions. So what is our inspiration? What drives me to do an action? And only when I'm inspired, my involvement will be 100% in that action. If I'm not inspired, if I don't get inspired by anything, my involvement will be very, very negligible. And that involvement shows that intensity of the energy and the effort we put. So it starts with inspiration. What inspires me to become extraordinary or to do an action? Please think. What is the inspiration we have? Just imagine. I think you all of you know Rani Abbakka, right? From the Konkan coast, where she fought the external forces. She defeated people also. That is the inspiration she got to fight. A woman in that age and that time, usually people don't come out that way, but she's a queen. She came out and she destroyed. What is the inspiration? Okay, forget about a queen, you say. What about a lady in the Shivaji's fort? If you go to Raigad fort, there is a gate named after a woman. She climbed down that gate in the middle of the night. How did she come down? What is that inspiration? What is that which made her to do an extraordinary action? It is the love. It's love for something. That love made her to get that inspiration. She derived that love from something which was greater, which she loved most. So what do we love in life? Do we love what we do? Please think. Are we doing what do we like? Love what we do and do what we love. Are we doing that? Are we thinking about it? So for that example, I would like to ask our Ganeshji. He is an organic farmer now, right now. He was in the IT field before. He was earning good money. Now he's become an organic farmer. What was your inspiration? Why did you choose to become an organic farmer, where everybody wants to be in IT field, wants to travel abroad, wants to buy great things in life and live a very posh life? Why did you become a farmer from being an IT professional? What was the inspiration?
Okay. Hari Om, Swami. So Swami pointed out, I basically started my life with IT. I used to run my own business. So it was IT based, and we used to do web hosting and things like that. And I was in this beautiful place, like you people live in this place called Goa now. I used to live in one more beautiful place called Ooty, you know, which is a hill station in the Western Ghats. So what happened was that I started a business, and the inspiration was there. And the point was my involvement. My involvement, I found that I was not able to involve myself. You know, I used to sweat even in that cold place. It is a very cool place, but you know, I used to sweat there also. So what happened is that I found that even though you may be making money, I was making some money, I was quite happy with the life that was going on business-wise, but there was no, the involvement in that. There was no intensity in what Swamiji has rightly pointed out. So the experiment went on. You know, like I couldn't find out. I did not think that was my swadharma, we call it. You see, it's your natural frequency. I found that it was not there in that I was doing. So then I went about doing a lot of other things over the next 4 or 5 years until I landed up, with a friend. We had a discussion, and then I got involved in farming. So last over a decade, I've been into farming now, and this is very different from the job I was doing. You know, like you have IT, then it's a closed office setting. You don't sweat much, but you know, it's you have everything in a closed setting. But here, I'm in the sun and we're roaming around places. But the thing is that I feel complete. You know, I feel that involvement is there. The intensity is also there in what I do. And I get to meet a lot of people, you know, and share what are the things that I do. And we find inspiration, like now we found Vignesh Chaitanyaji, who's inspiring us. Even this session, it's very inspiring. So the idea is that, you know, it is a kind of a search, a kind of seeking that we go on. And most of the times it's not possible to probably, from my experience, write down what you are inspired by or think about what you are inspired by. You just need, probably we need to go out, do something, check our involvement, and then you know that, you know you're not there. So a lot of experimentation probably. That's what happened in my life. And that's how I ended up from being in the computer field to being into the farming process now. Thank you, Swami.
Thank you, Kaneshi. So here you see a person who was very comfortable earning money, but he was not complete enough to feel happy about what he was doing. So he chose from IT to become an organic farmer right now. He is running a company called Desi Diet. And he is also not just doing organic farming. He is exporting Desi Diet, more of millets and stuff like that. It is such a big shift, right? Right from an IT company to an organic farmer. It's not an ordinary, it's a decision. So what is this DNA shift which you have seen? Is the DNA processing my life or something beyond this which is processing my life? How can a DNA suddenly shift from an IT to a organic farming? So that's what I'm trying to say. There is a consciousness behind. The DNA is a chemical reaction. The chemicals, how can it shift from this standard to this standard from a farming? So this is what we see in life of Ganesh ji, that how did he change the DNA for himself? His reflection. He was thinking, am I doing what I am doing right now is making me happy? His inquiry is seeking for the truth. So that is what we are seeing in Ganesh ji's life. And I'm also going to request our Swami Shugoshananji. Swamiji, what was your background and how did you become a Swami first?
I was part of Chinmaya Mission since I was a child in Balvihar, maybe from 1986 or from the sixth standard onwards. So I knew that there are various Swamis and Brahmacharis coming to our center in Madgaon. So there is a way of living a life, not just into Grahastha Ashram, but there is another way where you can be a Pracharak, an Acharya, and give this our values from our ancient scriptures to others. And I would say, as per God's will and Puj Gurudev's Krupa on me, that I got to join the 2 years Vedanta course. Actually, I went just for the 2 years course and I was supposed to come back and lead the regular life. But after doing the course, I felt ki, there should be some higher purpose to the life than just being a grahastha like any other grahastha. Okay, getting married, having children, raising them, and then die as a simple person. I said, God has given me this beautiful education by the knowledge of the scriptures, and which I loved the most. From the day which I entered this Sandipani, I was like, this is what I wanted, and I got it. I worked for 6 months after my graduation. I was a computer instructor in private computer firm. But there was nothing was very clear, and I thought this is not my Swadharma somehow. But once I entered Sandipani Ashram, the knowledge every day which I was getting from my Acharya Ji or Pujya Guruji and other Swamis, I said, this is what makes my life complete. So I chose to devote my life entirely for spreading this knowledge which I got from my gurus, Guru Shishya Parampara, to other people who are interested in receiving it. And I'm really fulfilled by being a Swami, or before that, a Brahmachari, or a Pracharak of Chinmaya Mission. Thank you.
Swami, thanks so much for your beautiful sharing. So such a beautiful presentation what Swamiji has done. You see, he was a computer instructor, and both, I didn't know Swamiji was a computer instructor. Both we got a computer person, and both of them shifted from computer to natural way of life. One is farming. He was doing agriculture of the land. The other is creating agriculture of mind. Swami Shugoshananji is dropping seeds of wisdom, and he's dropping seeds for food. So see how much of coincidence has happened. There is a software person creating nature, And here is a software person again, a computer person. Now, throwing seeds of inspiration to people around. So if you see in the life of Swamiji also, he was living his normal life. But one beautiful thing which happened in his life is his satsang when he was a child. And I could see Swamiji, both of us have the same thing. I was also in sixth standard. I entered Chinmaya Mission as a Balviyar kid. And then I got introduced to a lot of Swamis. My dear friends, don't think getting introduced to Swamiji becomes, you also will become a Swamiji. Yeah? Because some people may think, oh, when I get used to Swamiji, I also become sannyas. Not necessary. It's just a way of life. And Swamiji, when he took up this inquiry and search and went into Sandipani, his thought process has changed. Changed in the sense, his life, the way he approaches life has changed. He's also living like all of us. We are also living like the same as we are all living together. But the vision behind the life has been changed because of the knowledge which was given by the Shastra and the Acharyas. So now you see how he changed his life. How did he understand his Swadharma? He used the word Swadharma. Swamiji, explain that word Swadharma, Swamiji.
Swadharma is to do what you love. Not just love what you do, but do what you love. In this prachar life also, we have a variety of our Swamis and Brahmacharis serving our country, serving the Shruti Mata, or serving the our Pujya Gurudev. And every Swami and Brahmachari is unique in his own way. Brahmachari Vigneshji is, his USP is this conducting workshops and motivational talks. I had to discover my USP also while I was in Chinmaya Mission. It took me a few years, though I used to love singing right from my maybe third year or second year in the college. But I used to sing most of the film songs. But when I joined ashram, I turned that same singing into singing for God and singing God's name and his glories. So over a period of 7-8 years, I thought we can put this singing along with some pravachans and make a beautiful a garland of combination of both this, which I call it Sangeet Pravachan or Sangeet Pravachan Yajnas. So I discovered this pattern or this unique thing in Chinmaya Mission, or which I can do very comfortably. I myself enjoy it thoroughly. And when you enjoy yourself, then definitely people around you who listen to you also enjoy. So this is my Swadharma. Share the same knowledge which any other speaker, good orator on Chinmaya Mission is doing. But the way it is presented is through music. And that is my Swadharma. I discovered it in the course of my prachar work and really happy with it.
Thank you, Swamiji. So you found your Swadharma, though you chose a line in that just pravachan is there, but that pravachan also, the sharing of knowledge also, you find a unique way to present it to the people. Then how did you find it is because you loved singing and you know that was what is giving you joy also. We do a lot of things. We speak, we dance, we sing, particularly in this field, in this pravachan field. There is ways of presenting the knowledge and you found that the song gives you joy. Now you people, I think friends, you understand. Like, first of all, I need to derive inspiration. And how do I derive inspiration is, it's very important that we derive inspiration from what we love. And that is our strength. That's what is going to help us to reach our goal. So I request Jay to post to the slide number 6. What is this Swadharma, which Swamiji said, which is used the word. If you want to reach our goal, if you want to reach our happiness, what is that which we have to use is, we have to use our Swadharma. So what is Swadharma? If you see, that is the path of least resistance. You walk the path and you will not see much of a resistance in the path. When you start walking in a field, if you find resistance in that path, you understand that is not the way. There is something else. just think, okay, am I going in the right direction? Do we have to take another path? Think. And it's a natural calling. Does anybody have to tell us to eat chocolate or ice cream? People who love ice cream and chocolate, nobody has to tell. I will give you an award to eat ice cream. It's a natural calling. It's a natural inclination. And it should be unique and original. And everybody has got a unique quality in them, which we have to find out. And there is an authentic swing. For this, I will show you a beautiful video. Huh? And you should watch this movie also when you get the time. I don't know whether you have watched this movie before. I'm going to talk about an authentic swing now. Authentic swing, that original emotion that is all the time knocking at the doors of our consciousness. Are we listening to it? This is a very beautiful scene from a movie called Legend of Bagger Vance. I don't know how many of you have seen this movie, The Legend of Bagger Vance. It was inspired by the Bhagavad Gita, and the main character is Will Smith. He comes as Bagger Vance. This Bagger Vance is called Bhagavan, which made us Bagger Vance. And the hero is called Runolph Juno, which is Arjuna became Runolph Juno. And the movie is based on a golf. And the golf has 18 holes. And Bhagavad Gita has 18 chapters. So he is a caddy in this movie. Will Smith is a caddy, the one who carries the golf sticks. Like how Bhagavan Krishna was the charioteer of Arjuna, here is a person, a caddy, guides the hero on lessons of life. So I'm going to share this beautiful video. Watch the dialogue. It's an amazing statement he will give. Please give extra care to that dialogues which he say, and it will really connect to our idea what we're discussing. The authentic swing, the purpose, the meaning. How are we not finding it? Because of this reason.
Greatest game there is. Right, Hardy?
Yes, sir.
The greatest game there will ever be.
Just you and the ball.
All by your lonesome. Hey. I think it's time.
Time for what?
Time for you to see the field.
The field? I see the field, but it's 445 yards long. It's got a little red flag at the end of it. It's 12 strokes ahead of me. Come on.
That ain't it. Because if you seen the field, you wouldn't be hacking at that ball like you was chopping weeds out from under your front porch.
Just give me the club.
Sorry I bring it up. Hey, you gonna take that hack away.
What's the field?
Fix your eyes on Bobby Jones.
He needs a piece of work here right now.
Well, in the band room. Band room. Knock it out there, Bobby.
Is searching for something. Then he finds it. Watch how he settles itself right into the middle of it. Feel that focus. And he got a lot of shots he could choose from. Duffs and tops and skulls. But there's only one shot that's in perfect harmony with the field. One shot that's his. Authentic shot. And that shot is going to choose him. There's a perfect shot out there trying to find each and every one of us. What we got to do is get ourselves out of its way. Let it choose us. Look at him. He in the field. You can't see that flag as some dragon you got to slay. You have to look with soft eyes. See the place where the tides and the seasons and the turning of the earth all come together. Where everything that is becomes one. You got to seek that place with your soul, Juno. Seek it with your hands. Don't think about it. Feel it. Your hands is wiser than your head ever gonna be. I can't take you there, Juno. Just hopes I can help you find a way. That's you, that ball, that flag, and all you are. Seek it with your hands. Don't think about it.
Feel it.
Looking at it,
Juno.
Feel it. It's just
There's
you.
There's only one shot that's in perfect
that ball.
Harmony. You don't see it.
It's the home of your authentic swing, that flag, and all that you are.
So the authentic shot is ready to choose us. Are we allowing that authentic shot to choose us? Any action you do, are you feeling peaceful? Are you feeling happy? Are you thinking that this is what I wanted to do? Whether anybody is appreciating or not, this is what I wanted to live for. Any action it can be. Don't think it has to be a big action, serious action, achieving action. No, it could be anything like keeping a water on the stove to make it hot. Do I feel peace? Do I feel calm? Do I feel joyful? If every action, if you're consciously working on that emotion of finding out, like, yes, I am doing it out of no force coming from anywhere else. This is coming from inside me. And who is stopping anything? It's me who is stopping myself. We are here born with a natural flow. Each and every one of us have been born in this world to follow the natural swing, the authentic swing. So much of conflict and stress is happening in our life because we are not following that natural flow, authentic swing. Are we living our life or living anybody else's life? Swamiji chose to be like that. There would be, of course, so much of pressure from his family and the society. Why are you becoming a Swami? And Ganeshji also would have faced a lot of pressure from his family and people around, saying that, why are you choosing something which is not a norm in the society? The society thinks being successful and earning money, is this what life is all about? Is this what I want to do? When Mahendra Singh Dhoni sat on the railway station and reflected, do I want to be a ticket collector or do I want to play cricket? He did not play cricket for the sake of money that time. He was playing cricket because he wanted to play cricket. That is why he found himself. In every action, do you find yourself? Do you find aligned with what you are doing? Whatever it could be, any action, forget about success. Forget about being aligned with that moment. Please, people, this is the right moment for it. Please understand, during our time, we were all forced to do certain things in life. We didn't have choice. Our parents did not give us choice. They said, you have to read engineering, finished. You have to do this, finished. We just listen. Nothing wrong. We are not regretting that. We were able to choose because of the universal power, the guru, the truth, the Shastra, for me and for Swamiji. That could be the greatest strength for us. But for others, what should we do? Please never waste this life. It's a unique opportunity as a human. This is the place for us to live the way we want to live. Circumstances and situations can force us, which makes the other beings comply with it, but not the human. Resist it. No, I don't want to be this. I want to be what I am. What do you want to be? I'm telling you, parents will not say no. When they see you dedicated, sacrificed, and extremely focused on what you're doing, they will not say no. They'll always want you to be happy. Never say, my parents forced me to do. So what is this Swadharma we're talking about? We are getting lack of time. Why Swadharma is because we are not, the way we are connecting to the nature is what Swadharma will take us. So I will request our Jay to go to an exercise. 12th PPT, 12th slide. You go to the 12th slide. There, how to find our Swadharma. Can you all write? You have a paper and a pen with you? Can you draw X and Y axis? And in the middle, draw a diagonal line, X and Y axis in right angles, and a diagonal in the center. In the converging point of X and Y axis, write down your date of birth. Write down your date of birth. And in the middle, write down, write down what is your age. And at the end of the line, write down what is the date of expiry. Expiry. Every object has an expiry date, right? Manufacturing date, date of birth. Expiry date, date of death. Right? Date of death also. How long you want to live? 100, 120 years, 200 years. Write down your date of death. And right now, which age are you in? Mark it. And write three important events of your life which has happened till now. Very important happenings. I got a puppy. I got my first bike. I went into college. Something like that. What are very important incidents which touched your life? And write three things which you want to experience in your life before your date of expiry. Three things. My dream car. My dream bungalow. Lohit Shakti, can you share what you wrote? Lohit Shakti, are you there? Lohit Shakti, can you hear me? Not able to hear me. Okay. Padma Nayak, have you written?
Yes.
Can you share?
Swamiji, should I start from my date of birth or something?
You start with your date of before, after your birth, right now. From your age, three experiences you want.
Okay, want. Yeah. So first is, I want to get into a good medical college. Second is, I want to have a good family in the future. And third is, I want to travel.
Okay. This is your future take. Aditya Prabhu, you want to share what you did till your age now? Any three?
Yes, Swamiji, I got into the college I wanted. I'm very much interested in the subject now. I mean, the one which I'm doing now. And everything is well at this point. So those are the three good things that have happened till now.
Good. See, now this is an activity which makes us understand the entire life journey. We're able to see it, map it. So once we are able to visualize it only, we'll be able to work on it. Whatever we have done and where we want to go. If you're able to visualize it, it'll help us to proceed forward. Now we have seen the giveaways. Can you see the slide there, giveaways? In the screen sharing. Experience of sweet spot. When I'm doing that action, I am so joyful. Next. Complete confidence in it. When I'm doing it, I should have complete confidence in it. And always enjoyable. Whenever I'm doing it, it gives me great joy. And then when always inspires you, helps you to bounce back. Are you understanding what I'm trying to say? If all these conditions are fulfilled, then that is the sweet spot, authentic swing. That is what I'm supposed to do. That action again and again to reach my goal. You do it compulsively. Nobody has to tell you. You do it on your own. Yeah, I also can't see it very clearly. Maybe his network is very weak. That's why I'm reading it. It's effortless. Whenever you're doing, it should come naturally from you, spontaneously from you. And forms a big part of yourself. Yeah. Forms a big part of your self-concept. Feel you can't be happy without it. You should feel that without this, I can't be happy at all. So all these things you have to write down. Huh? All these things, you make a map on it. And whatever actions you're doing right now, whatever you want to do, just check it. Whether is it going along with it. You'll do it even if you're not paid or not appreciate about it. So if that is there, then that is the thing I should be doing in my life. Next one slide. So first step, what should I do? Spend time alone in silent introspection. This activity we need to do. Spend some time for your introspection. Be honest with yourself. Identify predominant mental and mood and texture. What is the predominant mental attitude I have and texture? And try to explore yourself. Explore yourself. Understand. Try to know what is his mind? Where is it coming from? What thoughts I'm coming from? Write it down. That's very important. When you start writing down your thinking process, you'll be able to see it better and clear to do what you want to do. Next slide. Things I enjoy. Make a list. What are things you enjoy? Things I'm good at. make a list. What all things I'm good at? Things that have always inspired me. What all has inspired you all the time? It could be anything. Things I do even if I wasn't paid or appreciated. Okay. 16th slide. Can you go for the 16th slide? We don't have time. We are losing time. Writing your vision statement. Can you write your vision statement? What is your vision for your life? What Padma said is a goal for your life. It's not a vision. Goals end when we perish in this world, or goals end when you fulfill that goal. But a vision is not like that. It carries beyond your life. Like Abdul Kalamji. 2020, he said, he was not there. He carried over. So what is your vision? How do I write a vision statement? I don't know how to write a vision statement. So we'll help you out to write a vision statement. Next slide. This is how you write your vision statement. After this session, take a chart and make your vision board. How to make a vision board? Checklist. It should inspire me always. It should give me unsurpassed joy. It should bring out the best in me. It should give me strength and confidence to overcome all obstacles. It should enable me to stay on track and bounce back. I should be willing to die for it. Write down the vision statement. After the session, you take a chart and write and make a board out of it. And we are also trying to show you how to write that vision board. Go to the 18th. My vision, suppose if this is the vision, it's an example. My vision is use my creativity and communication skills to challenge and reconstruct social ideology to achieve more conscious living and awaken society to a better quality of life. This is my vision. It is too big and complicated. How do I find? Yeah, next slide will help you out. So you should ask the vision these questions. Three questions you ask. What, how, and why? You should ask that question to the idea which you are carrying. What will I do? How will I do? And why should I do? If you ask these questions to your vision, and next slide. No, next slide. You have to go to the, okay. That's the side, okay. What, how, and why? If I go to the previous slide, if you see creativity and communication skills, challenge and reconstruct social energy. That is why you want to do. How will you do creativity and communication skills? What do you want to do? Achieve more conscious and awakened society to better quality of life. Do you understand how to identify that statement which you created? Question, what, how, and why? And this is a vision. But do I need a great vision? Is it a vision for me or a vision for the society? There will be two visions. One is vision for me and vision for the society. I have to align both the vision so that I will also be happy and the society also is happy. So if I want to have a great vision, yes, we need to have a great vision. A mother, if she thinks, my child I'm raising, if the mother thinks I'm raising the child for the nation, is that difference is there or not? Same vision. I raise my child for the child to be happy and make me proud. If the same mother thinks I'm raising the child to make the nation proud, is that difference? If that vision of thinking for the world is there, that brings the maximum potential. Personality and identification expands. Deeper perspective of life, greater impact in the society, and rise above the trivialities of life. So right now, go to the 23rd slide. 23rd slide. Next slide. See, this is how you plan your career also. How the Swadharma can be made as a profession. Finding the passion, leading to the profession, finding your purpose. Three P's. Your vision should take you to the three P's. Passion, profession, and then the purpose. The idea should take you to the three P's. So all you have to do, a little bit of homework you have to do. Go home, like you are at home only, I know. Take a chart, make a vision board, study the system, survive in the system, establish yourself in the system, and then change the system. This is aligning your Swadharma in the career to make a change in your system where you are. If you are not comfortable, or if you want to see the system grow. And this is the final last exercise you need to do, is go home and whatever we did, you know, that chart, please make it more specific, that X and Y axis. And the final concluding insights is, next slide, think about death. That's what we did, know. Death is there waiting for us at the end of the day. Death can be a great inspiration. Act right now. Don't be content being a spectator, be an actor. A power of one is great. You are the one, and that power is very great. Don't be afraid of your immense potential. That our potential is got so much, never shy away from it. You owe it to yourself to find a way and be happy. Even sky is not the limit for all of us. This is the ideas we need to carry. Use the Swadharma, find the passion, use it to propel yourself to the profession and find it meaningful and purposeful in your life. How do I do it? We have discussed about the chart to make it. So do a chart work and then we'll find. Sometimes hobbies, sometimes talents, we think it is our Swadharma. Need not be. Hobbies need not be our Swadharma. Talent need not be our Swadharma. Use it, all these ideas, to find our Swadharma. So hope it was useful to you. These ideas, please work on it. I'm thankful to Sugosh Anandji and the team, and Jay and Kaneshji, to share their ideas also. So let us all walk on this journey to find true purpose and passion, because otherwise our life is not fulfilled. We'll have to come back to fulfill it. We don't want to come back here. We have enough of it. We have already come so many times to this place. We have visited this place so many times in various forms. Let this be the last point where we go into the absolute, to live life fully with maximum potential. So thanks for your patient listening. Hope it was useful to you. And I would like to ask you, a couple of you, to give your feedback or takeaway. What would be your takeaway? Tritiya, is there any takeaway from this session? Can you share one point?
Hari Om Swamiji. I joined late, but from there, what I learned, I'll tell. Finding your passion and doing what you love. Even if you are in a particular career or doing something particular, and if you are not liking it, you can change it. I mean, that is not the end of your goal.
Very good, Tritiya. Good point. And anybody else wants to share? Rasika Joshi, you want to share? Any takeaway, any point?
Hari Om Swamiji. I learned a lot from this session, and the story which you told about that priceless diamond was very nice. I really like that story.
Okay, identify the diamond in you. You are a diamond. But the diamond becomes a diamond only when it is polished. When so much of things happen in the diamond, you have to be ready for such polish, such grinding. Then only that diamond becomes very expensive and costly and very valuable. Good. Chick Goa. Somebody said Chick Goa. Any takeaway? Any point which you think is good, I want to apply in my life. I'll remember and reflect on it.
Hari Om Swamiji.
Oh, kya baat ma'am.
I would like to share something.
Yeah.
Actually, I'm like a very much interested in dancing, but because of my subjects that I took presently after 10th standard, I was not able to continue. After this session, I felt that I should surely continue after some, like after my exams are done or whenever I'm free.
I'm very happy, Padma, for sharing it. See, please understand, we have come here to live what we want to do in life. You do what you want to do in life. That way, the impressions and the pressure and the stress will be minimal. This is what Bhagavan says to Arjuna also. Arjuna, do your dharma, swadharma, not paradharma. If you start doing something which the society wants or something which somebody else tells, you may be successful. All of you know Andre Agassi, right? Andre Agassi is a great tennis player. He married Steffi Graf. And he wrote a book also. In that he says, though I was very successful, you know, he dropped his career at the peak of his success. And he wrote a book. And he said, though I was successful, deep in my heart, I hated tennis. Just imagine, do we want to be like that? He was the most successful tennis player of his time. Jim Courier, Andre Agassi, they were all very popular. He was left, right, center. He was winning the American Open. He was open. But he dropped it. He stopped it. He said, I don't want. Now you see many cricket players are all dropping their career, saying mental issues, mental pressure. If you are doing what you are wanting to do, and if you're not expecting anything from what you want to do, then I don't think you will be under any stress or any pressure. You will be 24/7, you will be doing. Just imagine Gurudev. He gave every moment to the society and he was nowhere under any pressure. 42 years, he dedicated his life. Did we hear anything from him saying, I'm under stress, I'm doing so many difficult. 18, 20 hours he could put in a day. How did he do it? Yeah. Normal speaking, he also had the same blood and flesh, same bones, same brain he had. But how did he contribute so much? Because he did what he came to do. If you do why you came here, if you can do what you came here for, I'm telling you, at the end of the day, we will sleep peacefully. There'll be no moment in our life where we'll be pressurized, under stress, whatever it could be. There was a great rich man in US. When his son approached him and asked him, what should I do in my life after graduation or after fulfilling his whatever plus two or whatever it is? He said, whatever you do, do the best. Whatever you want to do, do the best. So whatever I want to do, if I do, I'll be the best in it. And I think you know Three Idiots also, no? In that movie, Amir Khan says, no, don't run behind success, run behind excellence. And you can do excellent only when you do what you want to do in life. Money will automatically follow. Gurudev always said, follow Narayana, Lakshmi will follow you. Now, if you follow Lakshmi, Narayana will hit you on the gada, on your head. Here, Narayana is wisdom, knowledge. And that is what we are to invoke in our heart to find our purpose, passion in life. So anyways, time has gone beyond. Thank you for this opportunity, Swamiji. I know questions may be there, may not be there. Swamiji will answer the question on behalf of me. He is always interacting with you. So I sincerely thank Swamiji for this beautiful session. And I thank all the participants also for patiently listening. Best wishes to all of you, invoking Bhagwan and invoking Pooja Gurudev's grace and blessings on all of us to find the real purpose in our life. Hari Om and best wishes to all of you. Thank you.
Thank you, Vigneshji. Our deepest gratitude to you for accepting our invitation. Thank you for this wonderful talk, inspiring us once again. Now I request